So today's talk is about the blood vessel and blood and circular vascular system. Yes. Last week, we had talked about 2 weeks about actuator. Before that, the muscle system, that is a leading creature's actuator. So the new actuators I have presented for 2 weeks. Okay. And today is a blood and cardiovascular system, circulation system, blood circulation system. Yes, this is a content. So mainly about the firstly blood, and focus on the blood, red blood cell, maybe the most important part of the blood. And then the vascular system and the growing vessel. It sometimes it looks like a mechanical injury. And also blood vessels work and the features, especially on mechanical features such as the material feature and also fluid features. Yes, so let's go back to the first part, the blood. Yes, I have prepared many videos, so it's okay only by showing the video, but I will briefly show about the outline of this talk. Yes, the blood, you may know hematocrit. What is a hematocrit? Hematocrit is the volume percentage, volume fraction of the blood cells. Yes, in the fluid, some blood cells are floating. So the hematocrit is the ratio of the volumes. Blood cells volumes. So the, it is the checked as a anemia, inket anemia. Okay? And in male, it is about 40 to 15%, and female, 35 to 45% is a normal value, it is said. And the pH, pH, hydrogen ion exponent, pH is also, maybe you know. And yes, this is normally about more than 7. More than 7 pH is acid or alkaline pH. pH 7 以上だとどっち？アルカリ3。pH acid or アルカリ。
酸性じゃありませんでした。
ファンさんどっちですか？この more than 7 pH is acid or alkaline?アルカリでね。
アルカリか。すいません。
Yes. The, yes. The, it, 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 yes. So the, if it is unbalanced, lower than 7, so it is become acid, the, it is become coma, and less than higher, not less than 7, the spasm, keren, keren. And also the arteric arrest. Arrest means the stop, cardiac stop. So that this pH control is also important. Yes, and how much weight of the blood is in the body? Yes, for example, it is a little bit heavier than normal water. 1.06 is a specific gravity, and it is 6.8% of the total body weight. Therefore, in 19 kilograms male adult, it is about 5.5 kilograms and 5.2 liters. Yes? まあいいや、ちょっとビデオはスキップして、if we have some time. And blood glucose.Blood glucose is also important. Many adult, elderly people suffer from the diabetes mellitus. It is this blood glucose become increased in the blood and the urine. It is this eliminated from the urine. So it is because of the hyperlipidemia or overeating, eating too much, and obesity. So the pain it is become suffered heavily, the severe injured and become coma. So this is very, very important. And this control is by liver. The glycogen is a main part, main element of blood glucose. So blood glucose is absorbed in the intestine and the stored in the accumulated and stored in the liver. And a part of the blood glucose is used. Yes, this is a good element to perform for the living creatures. So it is used as an energy source. But the normal value is about that, about this number. So the overmuch having this glucose becomes serious injury. Yes. And also maybe you know about red cell, white cell, and platelet. Red blood cell, white blood cell, and yes, platelet is here. So the platelet is makes a clot formation. This is to prevent the loss of blood for when we injured. Yes, maybe you know about that. And this is the distribution of the blood. You know where is the most stored part of the blood in the body? Yes? The blood is from the heart, and this is lung. And other part is, yes, other part is here. The blood circulation system is the artery part. This is blue blood, the red part. Artery part, the capillary is a small vein, and the vein is here. Vein is from here, from body to the heart is a vein. Yes, heart, lung, capillary, vein, and the liver and the spleen. And where is stored in the body? The blood is stored where? It is most stored part is a vein, this lower part, stored more about 40% of the blood is stored in the this part. Okay, and also lung is a one quarter. This thing, yes. Okay, so the blood is stored mostly in the yes, about 40% is on the this vein part, okay, vein side. Next is this is fluid dynamics. Some of you know about the fluid dynamics, but this is a little bit brief introduction about fluid dynamics. The Hooke's elastic body, Hooke's law. Maybe you know about the Hooke's law. This is stress, the force and stress. Force and stress is a linear, is a Hooke's law. And this is when it is applied to the fluid, the viscosity efficient. Viscosity efficient, viscoelasticity is the ratio of the stress and strain velocity. Some strain velocity applied, some stress force is generated. So this line is a Newton's fluid. This is linear relationship is a Newton fluid. But the fluid's viscosity is a ratio of shearing stress per shearing velocity. So shearing force is applied, shearing velocity is generated. This is a shearing velocity and shearing stress is here. So this is a fundamental feature of the fluid. looks like this, okay? And the wrapped cloth, wrapped is a non-Newtonian liquid, non-Newtonian liquid means the shearing force or the viscosity will be changed depending on its shearing speed of the flow. But this is because the blood is not only fluid, but also some cells is flowing on the liquid. So therefore, this number, for example, this 8 points, blah blah, 20, 28, 35, 48, is a hematocrit number. So the hematocrit number increased, the percentage of the blood cell become larger. Therefore, it is not a normal fluid, okay? Not only fluid. Therefore, the speed of the flow is become increased. It is more, this viscosity become increased. Yes, rate of the blood cell is become higher, and this blood cell is deformed. And lower speed, in the part of the lower speed, the blood cell become hemagglutinated and makes the rulo. Makes the rulo is the next part I will introduce. Yes, the blood cell looks like disc shape normally. Disc shape, and this diameter is 7 to 8 micrometers. 7 to 8 micrometers, and the thickness is 2.5 micrometers here, 2.5 micrometers, and the volume is 100 micrometers square, yes, and the number of the red blood cell is about 5 billion per millimeter square, and this is a male, and also the female is almost the same number. So rulo is agglutination. So the blood cell become, the ratio of the blood cell become higher. So it is the connected. It looks like a one-dimensional connection, linear connection, and more increasing the number of blood cell, it makes a three-dimensional structure. Yes, I will show this video. Red blood cell aggregation. Well, single cell, but it is formed like this linear connection. And the three-dimensional structure is formed. And the blood cell's deformation. Yes, blood cell deformation. Osmotic pressure. You know the osmotic pressure.
なんですかと言ったら、なんかこう液があって、yes, fluid here, and this is some membranes here, and this part is some small particle is here. When the small particle is here, it wants to become to go to there because the ideal condition is even density is the ideal condition. So therefore, this left part become higher density. So this particle wants to go here. So but this membrane cannot prevent from going through there. So that its pressure become higher. It's osmotic pressure. So by using this, normal condition is this disc shape. It contains some water part. And the 膨張、ハイポトニックソリューション means water and something is here. Hypotonic solution というのは膨らむと言ってますね。 So the atmosphere is so lower solution. So therefore, this part in the blood cell is a high density. Therefore, the water is coming into this blood. Therefore, this blood cell is become larger. Okay? To make the contents of the inside of the blood is the same as the atmosphere. Water become into come into the this blood cell. So the blood cell become larger. This part. Yes. So that this is that becomes a sphere, like the sphere shape. In the contrary, the atmosphere is high. Become higher, high density of something. The water inside the blood cell is coming out from the vessel, a blood cell. Therefore, it becomes shrink becomes small, and the volume of the water becomes smaller. Therefore, looks like the wrinkled shape. So this is a deformation of the. It is depending on the atmosphere, the density. Okay. Yes. This is one thing, one deformation. The another deformation is this. Normally, this is the disc shape, but it flow into the smaller vessel. Tank turret motion is a yes. どっかに書いてないか。この blood cell is here. The some part is the higher speed of flow, but this part is lower speed of flow. In this case, for example, in this case, this membrane is become rotate. Membrane is become rotate. So that this part is moving. Membrane become moving. So this is a tank turret shear flow field. Shear flow field is the speed of flow is different. Yes, for example, this part is high speed and this part is slow speed. So therefore, the speed of flowing is
different. Therefore, the, this part is the, this membrane is moved this part, and this membrane moved this part. So the, it looks like the rotating the membrane is a tank plate motion. And also, when it moves like the more smaller vessel, it changes total shape. So, therefore, it looks like the, like, まあ, こういう, yes, change its form, looks like this, change its form, looks like this. So, therefore, the, it is a slipper-like shape. And also, the, it is more, become more slower, the, it, each vessel, each small, each red vessel, red blood, become looks like this, so the, it's a chip fastener's shape.
I will show this video. Membrane flow is
it quickly springs back to its original shape because it has an extremely tough cytoskeleton. When the cell is placed in high salt solution, however, the shape changes dramatically. Driven by the difference in osmotic pressure, water rushes out of the cell, causing spike-like protrusions to form as the cell collapses.
For the solution into the solution fluid, this is a deformation of the blood cell. And next part, yes, this is an explanation about this blood cell's rotation. This blood cell's rotation. This is a shared flow, and this part is become high speed, and this part is a slow speed. So therefore, the membrane is moved looks like this. So becoming moving looks like this. This part is prolonged. This part is pushed. So the membrane is deformed. Therefore, it becomes broken like this. So it is one of the reasons of the anemia. Shape change, rotating, but the shape is, this membrane is also rotating. Tank threading streaming is like this. Yes. This is also the simulation of the flowing. This is calculated its stress of the movement, so it is broken its membrane. Yes, this is one of the reasons of anemia. Anemia is a insufficient number of blood cells, so it is many reasons. It is many causes. Iron deficient. Iron is the lack of iron makes the health condition become anemia. And also the anaplastic anemia, it means the bone marrow produce a blood cell, but some diseases, this function become lower, so therefore it cannot produce a hematocrit. Therefore, the number of blood cell become lower, and also other is also here. So to prevent this condition, you should eat various food. It has many irons. For example, soybeans or natto とか liver とか a kind of brown algae とか もずくって知ってます？もずく知らないか分かんないね。あるいは liver とかクラムとかオイスターとか This is a seafood, but spinach or down pine needle. I've seen these sliced and dried strips of daikon. Daikon?
Daikon.
Also, you should eat. So,
our red blood cells make up 40% of our blood's volume. They're made continuously in the bone marrow, looking like flattened donuts without the holes. Red blood cells contain hemoglobin, a bright red protein which gives blood its color. When we breathe, as our blood passes through our lungs, oxygen molecules attach to the hemoglobin. Then, the red blood cells and hemoglobin transport the oxygen throughout the body and release it to all our cells and tissues. When the hemoglobin molecules are emptied, they attract carbon dioxide and other waste gases, which they take back to the lungs to be exhaled. Anemia occurs when there are too few red blood cells or not enough hemoglobin. Exhaustion is the common sign of anemia.
Anemia. Hi. This. The changing its shape. This is a small vessel. This is a small vessel, capillary vessel. And this is a blood vessel. Red blood cell is here. It's deformed, so you should see. Yes, it looks like this. It's a small, yes, the capillary, the vessel is like this. It flows, looks like this. Okay. This is a one example of the blood flow, red blood cells flow in a capillary. Yes, and the lower video is this white part is a platelet thrombus. Platelet thrombus. So the it is formed here, and the flow is here. So the it is floated. So the this pipe can flow. Yes, it looks like this. Yes, this white part is become flow. So that it can flow like this. It is okay. But yes, this part is okay. But this platelet is moved to more smaller part, and more when it is when the, this smaller more smaller vessel is on in the brain, it makes some brain disease. Okay. So that this clot is make the many reason for the diseases. Yes, to move to the next part, cardiovascular system. The body fluid is about 60% of the total body weight. The 40% is in a cellular, but the 20% is extracellular. Extracellular is meaning the some flowing in the body. The it looks like the kidney. Yes, the blood plasma is 4%, and the lymph and encephalon. Encephalon is this is some liquid. This brain cells is floating is 1%. Yes, it is the number of the liquid part, fluid part. And blood vascular system and also lymph system is here. Blood circular. Yes, this is a flow of the blood circular. Some part is from the heart. Some part is flowed out and flowed in. But maybe you can understand this is a flow out number and flow in number is a little bit different. This agreement. It is caused by the this vascular wall. From this vascular wall, some part is out of this vessel and some part is into this vessel. But the out part is more than the inner part. Osmotic pressure, so the recovery, and some part is become lymph, and accumulated in some organs. And also, the, especially in the artery is changing its diameter. Vein is a storing part of the blood, so this is stored. Therefore, the blood transmission flood amount and return flood is different. This is sometimes it's not good for the mechanical or articulated heart, because articulated heart is usually the exhausting amount and the return part is the same, is a pump, mechanical pump. But the human pump is not the same. The exhausting amount and the return amount is different.
これなんですか? Blood circular system で understanding about the blood circular system. The component element is the heart and the blood vessels. This is a pump and blood cell is a flow resistance because the smaller pipe makes the resistance for the flow.
Circular resistance is not constant. It means, circular heart is a pump. From pump, the blood is exhausted, and blood pressure is it's the most highest blood pressure, high pressure here. But because it is the pump, to go to the body part, the section. Section area become increased. Firstly it's the main artery, but it is separated, branched into some body. So the total amount of the section area become larger. Okay? So therefore the flow speed is the highest in the just after the pump, but the flow speed is become slower and also the pressure is become lower in the body. But this system is maintaining this circulation. And also it is temporary changing from during the rest condition and during the exercising condition, physical training condition. The many kind of condition, it maintains its flowing. Why this circulation is maintained? Because one most important reason, aim of this blood circulation system is oxygen concentration should be maintained in the brain. Brain's oxygen concentration is the most important part for this blood circulation system. Hemoglobin density must be controlled, must be maintained. And also, other part, maybe you know, carbon dioxide should be exhausted as a lump, and also other waste product should be go to the kidney or other part, and also the some nutrient, some energy source should be brought from the digestive organ to other part, and also some hormone should be provided from the endocrine organ to the total body, whole of the body. So other material, substances should be transported, but the main part is this oxygen. Hemoglobin is the most important part. But this hemoglobin cannot increase suddenly. So the altitude training is very important. For example, the marathon race runner, the presently altitude training just before the race is necessary for the marathon trainers, marathon athlete.
Yes, maybe you know system circulation, body circulation, and lung circulation. And third is the coronary circulation. The blood must provide to the heart itself. So the third circulation, coronary circulation, is also important.
Blood flows through blood vessels, which form the closed system called the circulatory system. Like a system of roads, the circulatory system has its highways, back roads, and alleyways, which we call arteries, veins, and capillaries. In this lesson, we will learn about blood vessels and how they transport blood throughout the body. Each time your heart beats, blood is forced into large arteries. Arteries are blood vessels that carry blood away from the heart to other tissues. An easy way to jog your memory when thinking about arteries is to remember that arteries carry blood away from the heart. Because arteries are the first vessels that the heart pumps blood through, they experience the highest blood pressure. So they have thick, elastic walls to withstand the high pressures. These large arteries expand when the pressure of the blood rises and then recoil when the heart relaxes between beats to provide a smooth flow of blood through your body. From the large arteries, blood starts its one-way journey around the body, moving into smaller and smaller arteries and then into arterioles. Small arteries, such as arterioles, are less elastic and have more smooth muscle than the larger arteries. These smaller muscular arteries do not expand as much when blood enters them, and therefore provide the greatest resistance to blood flow through the arterial system, which helps regulate your blood pressure. The miles of arteries and arterioles in your body are simply transportation vessels and can be thought of as the highways and back roads of your circulatory system. Only the microscopic capillaries serve as a location for the exchange of gases and nutrients between blood and tissue cells. The capillary walls are very thin and composed of a single layer of endothelial cells, which are very thin, flattened cells that line the inner walls of all of the blood vessels. Capillaries are the alleyways that extend and branch into every tissue of your body, ensuring that every cell has a blood supply. It is here, in the capillary beds, that your cells pick up oxygen and nutrients and drop off carbon dioxide and wastes. The blood is now ready for its return trip to the heart through more transportation vessels. After leaving the capillary beds, blood starts its trip back to the heart by first entering venules, which are groups of capillaries that unite to become small vessels that drain the capillary beds. These small vessels, in turn, empty into larger vessels called veins. Veins are blood vessels that carry blood toward the heart from various tissues. veins are far from the initial pressure of the heartbeat and therefore under low pressure. Their walls are thinner than those of the corresponding arteries and their inner diameter tends to be larger. Because blood pressure is usually too low to force the blood back to the heart, veins require a little help. This help comes from one-way valves inside veins that prevent backflow.
One-way valve.
These valves might not seem too important, but if they were not there, your blood would not be able to counter the effects of gravity and would pull up in your legs every time you stood up.
Valve.
This would drop
so
your blood pressure
go back
to dangerously low levels. Venous return is also aided by the milking activity of the skeletal muscles. As muscles that surround the veins contract and relax, the blood is milked through veins toward the heart.
Yes,
kind of like squeezing the bottom of a tube of toothpaste.
Yes, it's really
blood flow back to the heart is further enhanced by pressure changes in the chest that naturally happen when you breathe, kind of like sucking up fluid through a straw. Let's review. Each time.
So the maybe you can understand the this vein has a valve, and also the role of the muscle is also very very important to go back to the heart.
Yes.
So the this is high flows hydrodynamics of the flow. As I said, the blood is a suspension fluid. Suspension fluid means not only the liquid part but also the cell, blood cell part is contained and flowing on the liquid, so that it is said the suspension liquid. So it shows non-Newtonian features, not only linear for the shear force and shear flow. So therefore, and also the blood cell deformed. And it has a resistance between the flow and the inner wall of the vessel. So the not only a fluid dynamics, but also some mechanical feature is also necessary to estimate the blood flow. Non-Newtonian liquid, どんなものだろう? Yes, very, very elastic and viscoastic fluid. Yes, it is looks like this. スローダンスとノンニューノリタこの、yes? Not only a smooth water, but this kind of liquid is a suspension liquid. Okay, so that it can flow on the surface. And also, some of the students know about the Reynolds number. Reynolds number is a very important for the fluid dynamics. It is a ratio of the inertia force and the viscous force. So the Reynolds number shows a feature of that kind of liquid. So the Reynolds number becomes higher. It is a turbulent flow. And the capillary flow, it is more viscosity. So if you are interested, you should learn more on the Reynolds number, on the fluid dynamics. Yes, and also the typical feature of the blood flow is unsteady. Yes, maybe you know the heart is usually heart beating. So the flow is sometimes stop and start. Suddenly stopped, suddenly flowed. So that this is intermittent pulse. Intermittent pulseous flow is there. And also the shape of the vascular system is very, very many kinds of, not only straight pipe, but three-dimensional pipe, three-dimensional figures pipe, shaped pipe. So it makes some various kind of flow inside the pipe. And also the other feature is this extensibility. As I said in the first class of this course, the blood vessel contains three elements: elastin, collagen, and the smooth muscle. The elastin is the elastic part, and the collagen is the hard part, hard member. And the smooth muscle is a muscle, is generate the by itself. In the altar, is the elastin is more than the collagen, so it is very elastic. It changes diameter, but the vein is not changing its diameter because the collagen is more than the elastin. So these three components ratio will change depending on the part of the vein. Yes. Peripheral resistance program might have skipped. Yes. Therefore, firstly about the large diameter arteries flow. Yes, this is the aorta. Aorta is just after the heart. The flow is, yes, this part is go to the brain, and this part is go to the lower part of the body. Yes, this is called the aorta arch. Arc is here. So the first high pressure and high speed flow is bent around here. So the artery could be next. Yes. So this is entry region. The entry region looks like this, but it changes its flow. And yes, firstly the lamina flow, but it changes to the Hagen Poiseuille flow. And also, not only the one-dimensional flow, but also the from outside to inside flow is also here. So that this is a very complex two-dimensional flow. Complex two-dimensional flow. I will show this video. Yes. No, これもなんかシミュレーションですね。なんかこれの前のページのやつ、前のページのやつ、これか。なんだ。ノーマルアート。The aorta is the largest artery.
fresh oxygenated blood through your aorta to deliver oxygen and nutrients to all your organs and tissues. Your aorta is divided into two main sections, the thoracic aorta and the abdominal aorta. The thoracic aorta has four parts: the aortic root, ascending aorta, aortic arch, and descending aorta. The wall of your aorta is composed of three layers that give it strength: the intima, or inner layer, the media, or middle layer, and the adventitia, or outer layer. The elastic muscular media prevents your blood pressure from rupturing the wall. Over time, degenerative disease may cause the media layer to break down, weakening the wall of your aorta. Blood pumping against the weakened area may cause it to bulge outward like a balloon. When this condition occurs in your chest, it is called a thoracic aortic aneurysm. These aneurysms may occur in one of several places, including the aortic root, the ascending aorta, or the descending aorta.
Oh yeah, if you have some interest in it, you should watch this video later. Yes, and turn to the thin, small diameters growth. Yes, this kind of blood flow, red blood cell is here. Red blood cell is concentrated in around this axis because around here is a higher speed of flow, and near the vessel wall, this is slower speed. So therefore, the blood cell is concentrated around this center, and sometimes no blood flow, blood cell is flowing more smaller part. Only the this is called plasma layer. Only plasma is here, no blood cell. And plasma skimming means no blood cell, and only skimming plasma flow is here. Yes, axial concentration it calls. And as I said, this is from the heart to the capillary, vein and artery, capillary and vein. So therefore the total diameter become smaller and again higher, decreased and again increased. So the pressure becomes slower down because the amount of the section area become larger, so the pressure forces become slowed down. And also the speed of movement is this is the highest amount of the section area, so therefore speed down and higher it again. And hematocrit number is also decrease and increase. HT hematocrit. Yes. Arterial and the capillary and venular. Yes, it looks like this. Yes, I will show again about this the actual centrated flow. It looks like this. Yes. これは何ですかって言ったら、Yes, small capillary is become, this diameter becomes smaller. Yes, again, I will show. Yes, this capillary becomes smaller. Yes. Yes, it shows the, for example, the someone is become, yes, suddenly look pale from red to blue like face color.
So it is make it is a it is by this, for example. Yes, the blood flow is become shrink. So therefore, the face shape, face color become red to blue, and also the blue to red is become higher. Also there, so you can find more videos. Yes, so therefore the applied force to the blood vessel is not only the circumferential stress, this is a diameter force, but also the shearing force and axial force is applied to the vessel. And also the vessel is deformed largely and non-linearly, viscoelasticity, incompressibility, and anisotropy. So that it is very difficult to simulate and estimate of the its movement operations. So artery vessel, artery canal is, as I said, three main parts, the intima, media, and adventitia, three parts, media, media, the intima, media, adventitia, three part is mainly. Yes. And as I said, the it change its diameter. Yes, change its diameter. The high pressure is applied, so the diameter become higher and store this vessel. And when the pressure is become lower, the it change its become smaller. Becomes smaller its diameter, therefore the flow is continuously applied. So the this operation is called window Kessel operation. Window Kessel is looks like this. So this Fuego blow bellows operation, bellow function. Bellows function is a window Kessel operation, it is called. Bellows. ちょっとこれ 3D アニメーションブラッドフローです。このダイアメーターチェンジ。3D アニメーションがあるんです、最近は。まあ、スタート・ストップ・フローっていうのわかりますね。スタート・ストップ・フローだし、まあ、フイゴ、チェンジ・イズ・ダイアメーター、で、You can start。In the other part, vein is yes, from the peripheral to the peripheral of the body to the center of the body, heart. So therefore, this valve is necessary to, yes, one-way valve is necessary to go back to the heart. Yes, and also the muscles role is also important, but it makes sometimes the varicose vein. Varicose vein is the one-way valve. So this part is become larger. So the some elderly people can see this some part of this is become large. Yes, maybe you know this one-way valve, check valve.
Varicose veins form. Varicose veins are swollen veins that are a blue or purple color. They show through the skin, usually on the legs and feet. Click the navigation arrows below the animation. information screen to play, pause, rewind, or fast forward the animation. The superficial veins lie below the surface of the skin. The deep veins pass through the deep tissues of the legs. They transport blood from the legs and feet back up towards the heart. The superficial and deep veins are connected by perforator veins. Here, we show the position of the deep veins, superficial veins, and perforator veins in the leg. The deep veins run between the muscles of the legs. Contractions of these muscles, when you move your legs and ankles, help to squeeze the blood back up towards your heart. Veins also have valves that prevent the blood from flowing back towards your feet. Here we show a valve and the muscles around the vein. Varicose veins are thought to develop when the valves don't close properly. Here we show a valve in a superficial leg vein. If the valves don't work properly, the blood is able to flow backwards. Blood pools in the vein, causing the vein to stretch. This is called a varicose vein. Here we show a vein that has become varicose. Here we show a varicose vein in the lower leg. Varicose veins may cause symptoms such as aching, itchiness, or swelling of the ankles. However, often they don't cause any symptoms.
You can see.
The main problem is usually their appearance. This is the end of the animation. Click on the animation screen to watch it.
Yes. Then this kind of. And the next is heart rate, diameter, and pressure. Yes, diameter, pressure, and it looks like this. So the, yes, there is a hysteresis. So the, this hysteresis is caused by its viscoelasticity of the vein vessel. And also the stiffness can be measured. Yes, this is a diameter. The ratio of the diameter and the internal pressure, diameter and the internal pressure is like this. And if we change this equation like this, the parameter beta is a stiffness parameter. It shows like the stiffness. So by using this stiffness parameter, stiffness parameter will be changed. This is a This horizontal axis is age. Maybe you are so young, about 20 or several years old. I'm 50 years old, it looks like this. The stiffness is not so higher, but after the 60 years old, this stiffness becomes rapidly higher. Yes, it means the aorta should be changed its diameter for pumping up smoothly, but when become elderly, so this smoothness changing of the diameter is become small. It's hard, so the it is so maybe the from 60 years old, the rapidly become hard of the artery, so it makes some cause disease. So it's not only the heart, aorta, but also some cardiac artery or femoral artery. It's the same sentence. So it's a little bit not so much changed around 60 years old. But after 60 years old, it is rapidly harder. It is a lifetime of our living creature's body. Okay. So it makes arteriosclerosis. Its elasticity and arteriosclerosis is a strong relationship. We cannot understand why this arteriosclerosis is happened. Yes, sometimes it is said that
sharing flow, shear flow become higher, makes this atherome, but slower, but in other estimation is making the slower flow makes this atherome. So I will show this video.
We are about to embark on a journey inside the body, deep into our arteries. Our mission is to find a killer, one whose work can start when its victims are still in early adulthood, and the diseases it causes are the leading cause of illness and death in the United States. This killer is atherosclerosis. Some people may not have heard of atherosclerosis, but the risk factors that contribute to it may be familiar and include obesity, elevated blood pressure, diabetes, a family history of heart disease, high cholesterol, or simply growing older. All affect our arteries. Some things we can change, like stopping smoking or changing what we eat, while others, like our family history or our age, we can't. But we can all take steps to reduce our risk of suffering a heart attack or a stroke by improving the health of our arteries. To understand how we can improve the health of our arteries, we will need to take a closer look. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. We are now in an artery traveling with red blood cells that carry oxygen to major organs throughout the body. And this is cholesterol. You may have heard about cholesterol, but did you know there are different types? The most important are LDL cholesterol, known as the bad cholesterol, because it can lead to clogged arteries, and HDL cholesterol, called good cholesterol, because it is believed to help remove cholesterol from the body. Generally, our aim is to keep good cholesterol levels high and bad cholesterol levels low. When there is too much bad cholesterol in the blood, this can cause serious problems. When there is damage to the lining of the artery caused by, for example, high blood pressure, LDL cholesterol is more likely to enter the wall of the artery. When LDL or bad cholesterol enters the damaged wall of the artery, it changes and can lead to inflammation. Over time, inflammation in the artery wall creates something known as a plaque. Plaques can start forming at an early age, and over time, this can lead to clogging of the arteries. This can happen in a number of different sites around the body and can get progressively worse over time. This chronic process, known as atherosclerosis, can become life-threatening depending on whether the plaque is stable or unstable. A stable plaque can continue to grow, slowly reducing blood flow over time by hardening and narrowing the artery, but does not necessarily completely block the flow of blood. But sometimes even a small plaque can become unstable and rupture, exposing its contents. This is much more dangerous than a stable plaque, because a clot can quickly form, completely blocking the flow of blood.
Oh, completely stop its flow.
As stable plaques form and cause narrowing and hardening of the arteries in the legs, the blood flow is restricted, sometimes making it painful to walk. Elsewhere in the body, the effects of plaque rupture can be immediate. A blockage in arteries supplying blood to the heart can cause a heart attack. In arteries supplying blood to the brain can cause a stroke.
Stroke.
So what can we do to help maintain healthy arteries? Addressing our risk factors will benefit our general health and the health of our arteries. We can stop smoking, change our diet,
stop smoking,
exercise more. With the help of your doctor, you can manage other conditions that may affect your arteries. Of course, some things, like your age or your family medical history, you can't change. If you were concerned about atherosclerosis and the health of your arteries, talk to your doctor about having your blood pressure, blood sugar, and levels of good and bad cholesterol checked. If you have seen your doctor and are being treated, continue to follow your doctor's instructions. Atherol, brought to you by AstraZeneca, is a movement to spread national awareness of atherosclerosis and empower people with the knowledge they need to improve the health of their arteries. For more information or to share this program with someone you care about, please visit www.athero.com.
Yes, United States, no. This promotion video is about 5 years ago. Because U.S. people is becoming the number of this kind of disease, injured people is becoming increasing now in the United States. So this kind of video is important to prevent, to reduce the health insurance cost. Okay? Yes. So this is the end of today's talk. It's okay.